afternoon. This is Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis. We're here at the Puerto Rican Day Parade in Hartford, Connecticut, and I'm standing here with Eliezer Mercado, young man. He thinks he's, you know, we're the same, and we're not. I'm like, I could be his, you know, his grandfather. But anyway,
I can't tell. No.
Hartford does that to you, man. It keeps you young, man. It keeps you on your feet.
Good.
But
good,
as you
good.
Can see here, Eliezer Mercado is running for Hartford City Council. And I'd just like to get a few comments on, you know, what's your position about Hartford? What do you want to do for us, and how are you going to represent your constituents?
Absolutely. Hey, I appreciate the time, by the way, as we're here at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Thank you for that question. You know, as a person who was born and raised here in the city of Hartford, I love the city. I'm heavily indebted to the city and what they've been able to do for me. And for me, while there's a lot of things that city council could focus on as the legislative arm of the city, you know, a few things for me is economic development, public safety, and quality of life. I think we're doing a good job in our downtown area, but how do we continue to develop the innermost depths of our neighborhoods, both from the north end down to the south end? And how do we truly hold developers to a PLA that really gets the Hartford residents working and have things in place of accountability?
Okay, now you know that was great, but now I want to ask you, Eliezer, I want you to talk to the common citizens. Not even common. What's the word I want to use? Keep it plain, make it simple. Talk to the folks like, you know, like your next door neighbor, you know what I'm saying? It's like, what is it that you see in Hartford that could be improved, done better? What is it that's lacking? You know, talk to the people, though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's keep this real.
You know, so the good thing is that
Eliezer knows how to do that.
The good thing is that, you know, we've been, myself and my team and volunteers, we've been out door knocking for the past 6-7 weeks. So we've been able to hear a lot from our constituents here in the city. And some of the things that we continue to hear, and it's been one of the biggest problems, is they talk about our streets being clean. Now, while we know there has to be a balance within residents doing their part, but also as a city, what are we doing to have cleaner streets? So what does that look like in regards to DPW, right? Start looking at some of the granular things in order to help that. Aside from that, you know, I continue to hear affordable housing also has another option. So we're talking about, and then they continue to talk about the crime rate.
About the rents being too high.
Absolutely. That's something I continue to hear about, is affordable housing. Hey, what about a sense of ownership? So what can we do differently? Some plans I have in mind that we'll share at a later day as we get closer. Exactly. But we're listening, and that's the most important thing. Listen, I, as a person, while I might know a lot, I don't know it all, right? And I believe that the best leader is the best student. So by me being out there with the people, it allows me to modify some of my platforms so they really reflect our community and what the people are saying.
See, now I like that. That's what I want to hear. I don't want to hear Eliezer Mercado's voice. I want to hear the people's voice through Eliezer Mercado. And that's what a real constituent does. That's what a real representative does. It represents the constituents. He's not coming wanting to make deals or gain power or anything like that. He wants to run because he wants to run for the people of Hartford, and not just one class of people or one clique of people or folks that are entitled or have money, but run for the entire city of Hartford. I'm so glad that we had this interview, Eliezer, that you got to speak your mind to the citizens of Hartford. We're here again at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. This is W4 News, and I'm Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis, and we're out.
Hi.
My name's J.C. McCauley.
I'm Naisha McCauley, and you're watching AccessTV.org.
Welcome back to the city of Hartford, the state of Connecticut. We're here in downtown Hartford on Main Street. This is W4 News, and I'm Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis. And we are here at the beginning of the Puerto Rican Day Parade in Hartford, Connecticut. And here are some of Hartford's police department's finest that protect our city streets. As usual, this is great weather. Unbelievably fantastic weather out here in the city of Hartford, June 2nd, 2019. Again, W4 News will be covering this parade from beginning to end. And we're also broadcasting live on Facebook. And so you get to see the behind the scenes of how we put this together. This is J. Stan McCauley is the producer of AccessTV.org. And he's covered this parade now for 3 years. He's also running for mayor of this great city of Hartford, Connecticut. So if you're Puerto Rican in the city of Hartford, AccessTV.org has been giving you a voice for the past, I would say, 25, 30 years. And this is a wonderful opportunity, and I love this parade.
Independent thinkers are Puerto Rican, Mexican, Peruvian, Indian, Bosnian, Italian, Irish, Jamaican, African American, European, straight, gay, Nigerian, transgender, Christian, Jewish, Muslim, short, tall, skinny, rich, poor, happy, sad. Some of us hold a PhD and others a GED. And though we may be Democrats, Republicans, or members of the Working Families Party, we all have escaped the plantation of party politics and become independent thinkers because we as individuals are more than a party. You see, independent thinkers come from all walks of life, and the one thing we all have in common is that we love, live, laugh, and learn in the city of Hartford. We are the constituents, and the government of Hartford belongs to us. My name is J. Stan McCauley. I'm an independent thinker, and I approve this message because it's time to stop towing the party line and vote for a candidate you can trust. I'm asking you for your vote November the 5th, 2019, in the general election for mayor of the city of Hartford. For more information, visit McCauleyForMayor.com. You too can escape the plantation of party politics if you have the courage to free your political mind.
Hey, we'd like to get a few comments on air here. You're on W4 News. What's your name?
My name is Jasmine.
Jasmine, that's a beautiful name.
Thank you.
Have you been coming to this parade every year now?
Every year, I don't miss it.
Are you here by yourself?
No, I'm here with a group of friends.
Oh, come on. All right, now, thank you very much. That's Jasmine from Hartford, Connecticut. Here we have the Hartford Police Hispanic Officers Association. It was established in 1984. So as you can see, Hartford is well represented as it pertains to the Latino community. And I believe I've said this every parade, you will find the Puerto Ricans and the Latino community in every facet of the city of Hartford, from the police department to the fire department. They're very community organized people, and we love that. Again, Pastor J. Stan McCauley has covered this every year now for the past 3 or 4 years, and it's an honor to be here to represent our Puerto Rican residents in the city of Hartford. How you doing, Chief?
I'm awesome.
I'm Marcus Jarvis from W4 News.
Yes, sir.
We'd just like you to say a few words about this parade and what you guys represent being in the parade, Hartford City's fire department.
Absolutely. It's one of our three parades that we have in the city. Obviously, the energy is amazing. A very diverse community coupled by a very diverse fire department. So we're proud of the fact that 35% of our Hartford firefighters are of Latino heritage. So we are here as a department celebrating Hartford today as we celebrate the Puerto Rican Day Parade.
Awesome, awesome, man. Great hearing from you, man.
You.
Keep up the good work, Chief.
You
hear that? 35% represented in the fire department, the Latino community here in Hartford, Connecticut. Again, this is Marcus Messiah Jarvis at W4 News, AccessTV.org. Here we have the Puerto Rican Parade Incorporated Hartford chapter. These are the people that put this all together and organized this for the city of Hartford, Connecticut. Awesome, awesome, awesome organization that makes this parade possible. Coming up next, we have Miss Puerto Rico of Greater Hartford, Connecticut. All right, everybody give her a hand. Now, as always, coming up behind me, one of the things that, because I'm a car fanatic, coming up behind me, one thing I love about the Puerto Rican community is they're always souping up their Jeeps, their Acuras, their Hondas, and you have a show of them coming up right now. I love the lights, the sound system, it's just awesome. so many different things here in Hartford, Connecticut, and you get to see them here at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Again, this is June 2nd, 2019, accesstv.org, W4 News, and my name is Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis. But we always interview every year, Mr. Vargas, and we just want you to give a shout out to Hartford and tell them what it means to be in this parade.
Well, you know, it's wonderful to be here and wonderful to see the leadership of the state and the city enjoying this wonderful day with the people of Hartford, especially the Puerto Rican community, and recognizing the contributions of Puerto Ricans to the great state of Connecticut, to the city of Hartford, and to all our major urban areas. It's wonderful that finally, you know, they recognize we're a political, economic, and cultural force in the state.
Yes, most definitely.
And that
that we're representative of every facet in the city of Hartford.
That's right. And you know, closely knit communities, you know, together with the African-American community, together with all the other communities that create this great fabric of the state of Connecticut. And that we're here to stay, brother.
That's it, man.
We're here to stay.
We're here to stay. That's it. It's our city now.
It's our city. That's right, and I really feel happy, you know, and proud that the people of Hartford have given me the opportunity to represent them at the State House of Representatives, and this is my fourth term. And I don't.
Yes, I know.
Luckily, I don't have any elections.
You're a lifer now.
this November, I have no elections, just municipal elections. But it's wonderful to be here and enjoy with the people, enjoy with the mayor, Luke Bronin, with our U.S. Senator, Blumenthal.
Oh, the mayor's here.
Yeah, the mayor's right here behind you.
Okay, Mr. Bronin, how you doing?
Good. How are you?
How's everything?
Oh, it's great.
You here by yourself? We got the family.
No, we got a lot of people around.
Awesome, man. Good to see you in the parade.
Good to see you, too.
All right, now, you guys take care now.
How do you define evil? Is it the pedophile school administrator or taxation without representation? Is it the gatekeeping community leaders who sell out the very people they are fighting for? Or is evil the politician that puts out lies and takes in cash? However you may classify evil, having to choose the lesser of two evils still leaves you with evil. Nowhere does this rule apply more than during an election for mayor. Choosing a candidate that is the lesser of two evils still leaves you with evil. No wonder so many people don't vote. It's time for constituents to flip the script and vote for a mayor you can trust. My name is J. Stan McCauley. I approve this message, and I am asking you for your vote on Tuesday, November the 5th, 2019, in the general election. I, like you, am an independent thinker. So let's sit down and talk about my path to victory and why my plan for Hartford will work. Stop listening to the uninformed evil interests that tell you I can't win. For more information, visit McCauleyForMayor.com. It's time to leave the plantation of party politics and free your political mind.
Say something to the citizens of Hartford.
La parada de Puerto Rico. Antes de Puerto Rico, yeah.
Puerto Rico, number one, baby.
There you go. Why is this parade so important to you?
Número uno. Que viva.
Arriba, Puerto Rico, number uno. You got that on W4 News, accesstv.org. Again, here comes my favorite. Here they all come. Now I'm a BMW lover myself. Yeah, you see this car? All right, man. Again, if you're just now tuning in, this is Marcus Jarvis of AccessTV.org, and we're here live June 2nd, 2019 in the city of Hartford, celebrating at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. All right, all right. I got a question for you. So, like, do you drive this around regularly or just for the parade?
I do regularly. I do. Yes, I do.
Now, how much work did you put into this?
Let's say at least 20 grand.
Wow. Nice, man. Nice, man. All right, everybody wave to the cameras. That's a disco on wheels. Well, now they call clubs now. There you go, we got clubs on wheels now, fellas.
Okay, here we have Sanchez School of Harper. Come on, Sanchez School, give it up. Here we are in Harper, Connecticut. This is the Sanchez School. As you can see, the Puerto Ricans and the Latino community are represented in every facet of this city. They take pride in education. They take pride in law enforcement, in the fire department. And as you heard Edwin Vargas, they're also involved politically. Well, this is the part that I love, because these are the future of Harper. Come on, give it up one more time. Come on, give it up. And here we have the cyclists. We'll call them the cyclists, Dan. There you go. Now, I've heard of hooking up cars, but this takes the cake. I mean, look at these bikes. They're all hooked up. As we say in Hartford, they're all pimped out, man. Look at these bicycles. I love that, the old Schwinn. Hey, I gotta ask you a question. So do you ride this around regularly, or you just bring this out for the parade?
Just for a parade.
Just for the parade?
Yes, for a parade.
Beautiful bike, man. I love it, man. What's your name?
Pedro.
Pedro, say hi to the people of the city of Harper.
Hi.
Thank you. What's up, macho?
Estoy bien, good, haciendo un homenaje para Gesto Macho Camacho. So, para ver si estamos en pie de guerra, como estoy vestido. El gladiador es macho time. Seguro, mami, look at that.
There you go, there you go.
Amigo, amigo. Thank you, gracias.
That's the new Pacheco and Cantifla of the day. Oh, that's the girl that walks around. There you go. She walks around the ring. There you go. Okay. All right, now I believe these are called short horses. Awesome, awesome. The Hacienda Oasis Monsonato from Massachusetts. What organization is this?
Achievement First, Hartford High School.
All right, you hear that? Achievement First, Hartford High School. Here in Hartford, Connecticut at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. To that sound, that is just awesome. One of the things you'll find in Hartford, you know, it's a small city that sits between Massachusetts and New York, and people pass through here. But let me tell you something, being a Hartford resident and a witness to it, there is so much talent in the city of Hartford, not just in the Latino community, but all across this city. Artists, architects, artisans, ballet dancers, musicians, singers, you name it, recording artists, recording engineer, we have it here in Hartford, Connecticut. And this is why investors come up from New York and come down from Massachusetts. Hartford is a gold mine, and it's a city that's always on the rise. And one of the great things that happens in this city every year around this time is the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Almost got taken out by a bike. Anyways. All right now, give it up for Hartford.
What happens in the voting booth stays in the voting booth. Even if someone wheels you up to the polling station after buying your groceries or paying you by the hour to door knock, you still can vote like an independent thinker. Vote like you're demanding better police accountability. Vote like you're demanding functioning schools that put Hartford children first. Vote like you're demanding your mayor puts Hartford residents and neighborhoods first. Vote like Hartford's government belongs to you, the constituent. Because to the party, you are just a vote. However, to me, you are a constituent, my boss. And I work for you. So when you go into the voting booth, have the courage to vote your conscience and vote for a man you can trust to be accountable to the constituents of Hartford. My name is J. Stan McCauley. I'm an independent thinker, and I approve this message. I'm asking you for your vote on Tuesday, November the 5th, 2019, in the general election for mayor of the city of Hartford. For more information, visit McCauleyForMayor.com. And remember, what happens in the voting booth stays in the voting booth. Escape the plantation of party politics and free your political mind.
Here we have the Rivera Memorial Foundation Incorporated. Aren't they just wonderful? Coming up behind them is the Latin Financial. You have a business, we have the funding. Here, say something to the people of Hartford, why this parade is so important to you.
This parade is really important because everybody comes united and we have a great time and just embrace the culture all together.
What's your name?
My name is Ashley.
And you live, oh, it's my daughter's name, nice name. And you live in the city?
I actually live in New York.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
So you come up here just for the parade?
Yes, and then I'll go over there next weekend for the parade.
I love New York Puerto Rican Day Parade, man. All right, now, you hear that? That's New York City coming to the city of Hartford for the Puerto Rican Day Parade. And this is what I'm talking about. When you see a communal-minded people that works across even city borders to unite and come together for this Puerto Rican Day Parade here in Hartford, Connecticut. And I love the fact that we here in Hartford have AccessTV.org, a voice of the people, W4 News. And again, this is Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis, and we're covering the Puerto Rican Day Parade. What an awesome time. All right, now. With X-Dance Tour 2019. They're located right here in Hartford, Connecticut. Again, as I stated before, Hartford has a plethora of talent. It is just unbelievable. That doesn't get as much media coverage as it should, but we here at AccessTV.org, we're bringing it to you live right here on Facebook and right here downtown Hartford, June 2nd, 2019. Again, AccessTV.org, W4 News, the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Here they are, bringing the flag. This is more of the same organization. Wow. Awesome, awesome. Give it up, give it up, give it up. What's your name?
Louis Metcalf.
All right, man. That's Louis, man, from Hartford, Connecticut. All right. Stan, I wonder how much Luke Bronin paid to get in the race. Was it campaign funds or his own personal money? Just a question. Just a question. Here we have behind you CT Connecticut! Here comes the CT team now. So many different wonderful organizations here. If you don't know what Telemundo is, it's a TV station, and they broadcast Spanish programs. Like I said, Latino Latino community is represented next day. I just got a real big smile. But anyway, Latino community is represented again in every facet of the city of Hartford. Here we have Hartford. We gotta let it. Give it up, Hartford. Come on, give it up for the camera. So I just got handed from this organization, Hartford Athletic. A pro soccer. Pro soccer is actually already put together. Pro soccer is here in Hartford, Connecticut, and you're getting it first from AccessTV.org. This is W4 News at the Puerto Rican Day Parade in Hartford, Connecticut. Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis. Awesome, awesome. Pro soccer is here in Hartford. All right now, give it up, give it up. Eye Care Health Network, that's what we have coming up now, Stan. Eye Care Health Network at the Parkville Care Center. Come on, Parkville, give it up for Hartford! For you. First of all, what's your name?
Juan Pagan.
Juan Pagan. Juan, how much would you money would you say you've put into this vehicle?
20.
20 grand?
Yeah.
And do you bring it out just for the parade or?
Only for the parade.
Just for the parade?
Yes.
Wow, man, beautiful, man. Great work. We're great. Hey, listen, I want to give you this. You're on W4 News right now. If you want to go see the program, check out the network. Growing up in the city of Hartford, this is one of the things I love, is when kids get on out from in front of the Nintendos and the Ataris. Oh, I think I'm showing my age. Xboxes, I believe they're called. And they get out here on these bikes and they do all kinds of stunts. I love it, I love it. Again, look at Hartford. Hartford is an amazing city, again, with just unbelievable talent, unbelievable talent. Let's walk up here more, Stan.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Okay, as you can see, this is Goya. I didn't know what she was saying. I thought she was calling my name. She was saying, Goya, Goya. Well, anyways, we're here back in Hartford, Connecticut, accesstv.org, W4 News. And my name is Marcus Messiah Jarvis. I'm covering this wonderful Puerto Rican Day Parade, June 2nd, here in Hartford, Connecticut. And as you've heard me said before, Hartford is full of talent. I mean, just listen to this. This is live. As a mega Hartford. Hey, what's up? Hey, how you doing? Oh, he's live on Facebook. This is more of Mega 101.7 Hartford, Connecticut. Once again, Hartford representing the fire department, police department, emergency response, political. Hey, Stan, you got to get a load of the dancers behind the float. This is the last of it. This is the last of Mega Hartford. All right, great future start here, Boys and Girls Club. Give it up, give it up, give it up. Hey, if you want to watch this, you're on W4 News. What's your name?
Sue Haley.
Sue Haley. Sue Haley? Are you
the
Sue Haley?
Yes.
Oh, awesome, awesome. Vega Strong Family Cassandra. Tell us what. Oh, hey, Cassandra, how are you?
Good.
So tell us, why are you in the parade? What is this about?
It's about your culture, right? But more importantly, it's about her fight with leukemia. And they're marching for her, the family, and she's doing like every year, nothing is stopping her. She's marching.
Okay, awesome, awesome, awesome. And so you're raising money for this?
No. This is, Dad is actually part of the board. But Cassandra marches every year, and she just wants to show that no matter what she's going through, she's still here.
So would you say you're a fighter, right?
Yes.
And that you can beat anything, right?
Yeah.
That's right. You believe that. You keep believing that, okay? Mm-hmm. God bless you. And I'll be praying for you. Nice to meet you, Cassandra. Hartford, Connecticut, I'm telling you, only in Hartford, Connecticut. Here we have a young lady named Cassandra. Cassandra, wave, just wave, Cassandra. Who has leukemia, and she's fighting for her life. I love the passion that we have in the Puerto Rican culture and in the Puerto Rican people. They are fighters and they are uniters. Here in the city of Hartford at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Very touching story, very touching story. Love it. Okay, coming up next, one of my favorite people in the city of Hartford. He's represented us. As you can see, his big signs coming in the background is Jeffrey Dressler. Jeffrey Dressler, Dresser at Law. But first, let's give these people a shout out. Come on, everybody, give a shout out. You're on the camera. Now, if you hear what he's calling out, are all the different communities from Puerto Rico, San Juan, Arecibo, Yabucoa, many, many, many of the towns. Excuse me, towns and pueblos in Puerto Rico. Hey, it's Dressler himself, man. Say something to the citizens of Harvard. Come on down, Dressler. I have your.
All right, now, what do you think of this day?
Awesome, awesome, awesome
all
day.
Right.
Perfect weather.
You know what I love?
What?
We're celebrating our Puerto Rican community as we celebrate all of our communities. This is what is part of making Connecticut great. Right?
Awesome.
We're going to celebrate the contributions in every area that we have. Medicine, legal, engineering, music,
fire department,
art,
police,
everything.
Fire, everything.
But we make Hartford a great place. This is bigger than better than any year in the past. What do you think?
Yes, it is.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Today, everybody's Puerto Rican.
Amen.
Huepa.
Huepa, Puerto Rico. All right, there you go. That's attorney Jeffrey Dressler. He has been a representative on so many levels of the Hartford City residents. There you go. Look at him, salsa. Go ahead. And these are all his supporters. Everybody give a big shout out for Jeff. There you go. I believe I said, oh, this is the Eddie Perez campaign. And Eddie was once the mayor of the city of Hartford. So as you can see, I don't see Eddie though. Where's Eddie? You see Eddie? Where's Eddie? Oh, they said he's come. Where? I don't see. There he is. Okay, this is Eddie Perez right here, former mayor of the city of Hartford. Eddie, just say a few words to the city of Hartford residents, man. We want to hear.
This is a good day. This is a good day to celebrate the diversity of our city, all the contributions that people make. Today we're celebrating the great island of Puerto Rico, my birthplace. I'm considered a little bantam from Corozal, Puerto Rico. Everybody's enjoying the parade. I'm glad that we're having such a sunny day. And this is the way Hartford should be every day, celebrating us. Enjoy the parade.
Thank you so much, Eddie. Thank you so much. Hey, God bless you. How you doing, sis?
You give you a candy because you're so sweet.
Oh, okay. Again, former mayor of the city of Hartford, Eddie Perez. Eddie Perez, folks. Eddie Perez. Moving right along, behind Eddie Perez is Caguas, or Caguas. Use the new tires. All right, give it up, give it up, give it up. I'm sorry, this is hot 93.7. High 93.7.
What's going on, Jesse? Let's go. Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
We want to catch the broadcasters on that show.
Let's go! The Turn It Up Show, the Turn It Up Show. What we doing? What's up, Stanley? Access TV in the building. Let's go! Yo soy Boricua! Yo soy Boricua!
Again, awesome talent in the city of Hartford.
Let's go!
Coming up behind 93.7 again. You hear that? All right now. This is one of the many car clubs. Yes, I said it. This is one of the many car clubs here in Hartford, Connecticut that the Puerto Rican Day Parade at the Latino community represent. Coming up behind them is the Heartbeats. Is the Heartbeats Dance Crew. Okay, I want to interview some. I'm going to interview you. What's your name?
Amarellis.
Amarellis?
Yeah.
Okay, y'all keep walking. Keep walking, folks. What is the Heartbeat Dance Center?
Heartbeat Dance Crew? It's our dance place where we dance and we show our affection to dance.
And what kind of dance do you do?
Hip-hop.
It's all hip-hop dance?
Yeah.
Okay, and you're all from the same school? You live in the same neighborhood?
No, we don't. We come from all different places and neighborhoods.
And why is this Puerto Rican Day Parade so important to you?
Well, because I'm Puerto Rican, and it also shows that we care about people and about their culture.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. This is Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis, AccessTV.org, W4 News, here in Hartford, Connecticut, June 2nd, 2019, the Puerto Rican Day Parade.
Every bad political decision is made by a politician elected to office. So if you think your vote doesn't matter, just remember this. There are people sitting with politicians in a back room making deals about your future, making policies about your children, making decisions about your neighborhood. To them, you are just a vote. You are not their charity. You are not their cause. You are just a vote. Elections have consequences, and if you don't vote, you are actually voting to keep these people in power to work against you. Now, more than ever, you need to make your vote count. It is time to clear the air and vote for a mayor who is unbought, unbossed, trusted, and accountable to you, the constituent. My name is J. Stan McCauley. I am an independent thinker, and I approve this message. I'm asking you for your vote on Tuesday, November the 5th, 2019, in the general election for mayor of the city of Hartford. For more information, visit McCauleyForMayor.com. Declare your independence from the plantation of party politics and free your political mind.
Hartford Proud right now, man. What's up, man? Oh, there she is. God bless her. Now, she, introduce yourself.
I'm Terry Starks from Hartford Proud Trail Drum and Dance Corporation.
And she put this organization together, right?
I sure did.
How long you been doing this?
7 years.
7 years. This is just one of the many community residents that out of the passion of her heart wanted to do something for the kids. And she brought us this music and wonderful drum and dance troupe.
Keeping our kids off the street.
That's right, taking the kids off the streets, all right, and giving them something positive to do. This is what I love about Hartford. Now, Hartford's not just a pass-through where people just move in and move out. No, it's local residents get involved. Hartford proud, folks. Hartford proud. All right, Hartford proud, Stan. All right, now. More of the same, folks just hooking up their vehicles and showing their support. How you doing? For the Puerto Rican Day Parade here in Hartford, Connecticut. Said that the average, they put $20,000 into one of these vehicles. Look how much money's rolling down the street. Bomba 97.1 Hartford, 98.5 Meriden, 99.5 Waterbury, and 104.5 Bridgeport, New London, and Springfield. Those are all the Latino radio stations where you can get the best of salsa, the best of bachata, of merengue, and all the other Latino styles of music. Hey, what's up? That's Corona. Now, some folks may not like them because they tow your car, but you can also get awesome car parts at Corona. Again, Stan Bomberato. Radio.com. Here we have, it said Luke for Hartford. Here we have Luke Ronan for the city of Hartford. That's the mayor that we saw drive past us not too long ago. How you doing, man? To watch it on accesstv.org. You're on accesstv.org. Behind them is the Los Humildes Connecticut Kart Club. All right, now these look like the Toyotas and Hondas. Watch it tonight, W4 News. All right now, man. I'm watching you. You watching me, man. What's up, man? All right now, that's Hartford for you, man. Here we have Nick LeBron. Hey, what's up, man? The city council. You Nick?
Yes, I'm Nick.
All right, everybody. This is Nick Cabron. He's running for the city of Hartford.
Yes.
Nick, you're on W4 News. Just give us a few words on why you want to represent Hartford.
Oh, basically, we're a grassroots movement, as you can see. We're purpose, people, in progress, right, for 2019. We got to have courageous conversations that's committed to the future of the city of Hartford.
That's what's up, bro. That's what's up, man. That's what I want to hear. All right, real people, real politicians. All right, now, W4 News. Hey, Nick. Ice cream, what's up? What is it? What's Dream Chasers? Tell us about it.
Dream Chasers, so ice cream for a dream. We distribute ice cream for just one dream. So if you got a dream, you get a free ice cream. Free ice cream to everybody. Just all you gotta do is provide a dream.
Awesome, we wanna support that.
Thank you. Thank you, appreciate it.
We'll no problem, it. Man. Who? Yes, most definitely. Hartford Healthcare, cuidado de salud para todas las comunidades. This is Pastor Mark and Messiah Jarvis. We're here in Hartford, Connecticut at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. We saw a few businesses pass by. Here we have Shaw Chiropractic, located in Hartford, East Hartford, New Britain, and Middletown. And here we have the Connecticut All-Stars. What's your name?
Shani.
Shani, tell us about your organization.
This is CT All-Stars. We're just a dance crew. We're basically formed by youth kids ages 10 to 17, and we do hip-hop.
How do you get funding?
Oh, it's just us.
It's just you guys.
It's just us, yeah.
Well, listen, I want you all to check us out. You'll
Thank
see
you.
On accesstv.org.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
No problem. Bye. And we want to support you. We want to support you. We got here who? Who?
McGee from Mayor!
McGee from Mayor, okay. I don't see McGee. Where's McGee? How you doing? God bless you. Let's see if we can go find Brandon. Where's Brandon? Oh, they, how you gonna walk up? Come on now, man.
I see you, I'm in the parade, man.
All right, Brandon, hey, stand. We got him here. Okay, so Brandon McGee is here on W4 News, accesstv.org, and he's running for mayor. Tell us why you wanna represent the people of Hartford.
Hey, man, I wanna represent the people of Hartford. Where am I looking, in the camera? I want to represent you because I am a part of this community. You know my history. I care about equality in this city, affordable housing, criminal justice reform, you name it, seniors, education, but most importantly, all of the people in the city of Hartford. So I'm here celebrating the rich culture of our Puerto Ricans in the city of Hartford, and I'm glad that you guys are out here covering this.
Awesome, program. Awesome. And thank you for everything that you're doing on the state level, too. State Rep. Brandon McGee. Thank you. Thank you. Hairspray, what's up, man? How you doing?
God bless you.
Okay, tell us what Hairspray is.
So Hairspray, we're at the theater. We're doing Hairspray June 13th, 14th, and 15th. You got to come see us. We got 65 kids from over 30 schools. It's going to be so much fun. You got to come see Hairspray.
You hear that? That's why I love this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful
you gotta
city.
Come see Hairspray. Act Up Theater, we're everywhere.
Now, where's Act Up Theater located?
Act Up Theater is going to be Classical Magnet, June 13th, 14th, and 15th.
This is what comes out of Hartford schools, right?
Yes, we're quality. We give quality theater to our community.
All right, if you want to catch this, you got to look at it on accesstv.org, W4 News. I see, they know. Hey, how you doing, Darius? Look at you getting big, man.
I'll see you later.
All right, now. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, I bought those sandwiches. Mira, comida, I'm hungry, man. Where the food at? All right now, thank you, thank you. All right now, all right now. Who we have here? DJ Popo. DJ Popo. From Hartford, Connecticut. Like I said, Hartford has so much talent, man. So much talent. Give it up, give it up. DJ Popo. So if you have a wedding in the city of Hartford and you want some great salsa music, awesome sound system, call DJ Popo. Ivy Queen Reina. That's Ivy Queen.
Junio 29.
Tell the folks on the camera what Ivy Queen.
Para junio 29 en favela.
Oh, okay, okay. Coming up behind them is Puerto Rico Express Tire, 5596 East Main Street, New Britain, Connecticut. The one thing about the Puerto Rican Day Parade is they come from all the local towns to join this parade. This is not just Hartford. This is New Britain. This is New London. All over from New York. That's what I love about the Puerto Rican Day Parade here in Hartford, Connecticut. And we have more souped up, pimped out cars. How you doing, sir? Okay, coming up behind now is the Sand School. Sand School. All right. All right, Sand School, give it up, Sand School. This is Sand School here in the Puerto Rican Day Parade here in Hartford, Connecticut.
Who needs that credit fix?
What?
Who needs that credit fix?
Oh, okay, so tell us what you do.
So what we do is that we help expose financial literacy. So this is very important. So if you want to get a house, even if you want to get a job, you could be going to school and getting your degree, but if you don't got good credit, there's some jobs that won't even take you.
Where are you located?
We're located in Springfield, Massachusetts. My name is Francesca Castañeda, by the way.
Okay. How did you come to be part of this Puerto Rican Day Parade? I'll walk with you.
So we're here right now with our vice president. Her name is Raisa Artero. She's doing big things in this business. She was able to get this car with the R&R Club. So now that means that the company is actually...
She, the company actually paid her in this car for doing such a for building a big organization. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I want to introduce you because she's somebody big. How you doing? I'm Marcus Jarvis from Access TV.org. You're on W4 News. Welcome. Hey, W4 News, what's going on? And so she said you're located where? That's right, I'm the vice president of our organization here, one of them, and what we do, we're located out of Springfield, Mass, but we're nationwide.
Okay, so we're here at Hartford as well. Right, we're nationwide. So now we're trying to get other markets, trying to bring, obviously, financial literacy and helping people restore their credit, but we also actually bring on agents to help us so that we can reach everyone nationwide. Awesome, awesome. It was nice meeting you. Let me give you a card so you can check out your interview on Access TV.org. Thank you so much. Here at the Puerto Rican Day Parade, again, the Latino community is represented in every facet of life. That was about credit restoration for people who want to buy a house here in Hartford or in the surrounding areas. It's just a community-based people. I just love it. Coming up here is the Hartford Parent University. Give it up, Hartford Parent University. Awesome, awesome, awesome. HPU! So tell us, what is HPU all about?
HPU, we teach parents how to advocate for their children's learning.
And what's your name?
Millie Arciniegas, the executive director.
Oh, you're the executive director.
That's correct.
Hi, I'm Marcus Jarvis. I'm from AccessTV.org,
okay.
W4 News.
Okay.
Oh, that's the wrong card. Sorry about
wrong
that. Oh, I ran out of cards. Give me a card. If you want to see this interview, there you go. Come check us out. Mariachi Nuevo. How you doing, guys? Come on, give it up. Come on. Ponce. Hey, what's up? One of the many towns and pueblos in Puerto Rico. Ponce is one of them. All right, give it up, Ponce. All right, here we have Daybreak Adult Services. Stan, that can't be it. Well, we are here at the conclusion of the parade here in Hartford, Connecticut. We had an awesome time. It's not over, though. The parade is just a prelude to many other celebrations in the city. Here we have coming up behind us, Hartford's Finest. Hey, keep it down, folks. But anyway. So again, here we are at the end of the parade and we have some of Hartford's Finest. It was an awesome day here at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Beautiful weather. Again, you got it first from AccessTV.org, W4 News. This is Marcus Messiah Jarvis. And again, what an awesome day. But after this, I'm sure there's going to be many block parties, many private parties, public parties. The whole city is just going to be on party. They're all going to travel down the bush. They'll have a big party over there. And this is what the Puerto Rican Day Parade here is in Hartford, Connecticut. Last but not least, you know, W4 News is from AccessTV.org. They're impartial. We give a voice to everybody. So I want to give a voice to J. Stan McCauley. J. Stan McCauley is the voice of the people, for the people, by the people. He has given this city a voice for the past 30 years, and now he wants to give everyone a voice and some political real estate down at City Hall by becoming your next mayor. Again, this is Pastor Marcus Messiah Jarvis, AccessTV.org, W4 News.